such a treat. And we got some incredible people here tonight. And I just want to, you've seen a couple on the platform right now, but I want to introduce them to you right now. This guy on my left right here, he is from here. He has the Farmers Opry. It's in Milton off of Chemukla, near Milton and Jay. And this guy was on the road for 17 years, six nights a week, playing music. And he got off the road and just stopped playing for 5 years. And when he did, he said, I need to do something a little bit more family friendly. And he opened up the Farmers Opry. And if you haven't been there, I think on October the 18th, they're doing another fundraiser for the Living Truth Church. And go on Sandy's website, it's right there. Mr. Sandy White, would you make him welcome? Yes, because the building was on fire. Not yet. The fire truck hadn't come yet. So. Yeah, give us a minute, though. And I want to introduce the lady on piano. I want to tell you the story of her. She played a piano recital kind of, in a talent contest when she was 12. And I was sitting in the audience, and she played this beautifully. And she won the contest. And I came up to her and I said, where did you learn to play? And she goes, on YouTube. And I was like, wow. I said, has anybody ever taught you the chord structures or anything? And she said, no. So I began teaching her. And she was my student for up until 2 years ago. And she came up to me about a year and a half into piano lessons. And she said, I got this song I'd like to do at the talent contest at school. And I said, great, what is it? We'll play it. And she goes, actually, I want to sing it. And I said, you sing too? And she said she wanted to do Billy Joel's New York State of Mind. So she did that, and she starred in numerous plays and musicals in high school. She is now the co-worship leader at my old church. She's now the co-worship leader at First United Methodist in Oviedo, and she just got that job like last week. So please make welcome Miss Nikki Montgomery. The song we're going to do right now is a Johnny Cash song, and it's not Pastor Allen's ringtone either. So his ringtone is that's Allen's ringtone. So. But this is a song by Johnny Cash. One, two, three, go!
Ground. Oh.
tell y'all something. Y'all are just being so nice right now. You've been seated for about a half hour. This is the time I'm going to ask y'all to stand right now. And you're not only going to have to stand, you're going to have to participate right now. Okay? And everybody's going to sing this song because I think everybody knows it. And most of you. With these individuals, not only tonight, but every Sunday. It's just a privilege. And I just want to recognize folks you don't see right now, because there's Barry Powell, Elizabeth Powell, and Nathan is back there in the back running the sound, and somebody's running video also. Taylor's running video. Would you all give them a nice round of applause? And thank them. And while I'm at it, he always gets at the end of the line. So tonight, I want to make sure he's first in line. So if you would, on rhythm guitar, please welcome Cal Van Duren. Right next to him is Nikki Montgomery. Also in the back in the vocals is Linda Davis. Right next to her is Christina Skilton. And Jamal Boast is right here. And his mother just flew in from Montana to be here tonight. Isn't that awesome? On the drums is John Davis. And back right behind me is Robert Trigg. And right behind him is Charlene Withy. And Mr. Sandy White right here. I want to tell you about this church. I've been here for 2 years right now, and when I came here, it was in September, and right in September, I was supposed to be here the week after Labor Day, and I called Pastor Allen. I said, man, I don't know if I can be there. Hurricane Irma is about to hit Orlando, and I really don't want to leave Vicki here by herself with a hurricane. He said, well, that's quite understandable. So I stayed in Orlando, and Hurricane Irma came through town, and it knocked out trees in our neighborhood. Our house was fine, but it took us a few days to pick up all the stuff that was scattered around the streets, and we didn't have no power for 8 days. And Alan called me, and he said, how you doing? I said, well, we survived the hurricane, we're okay. But he goes, you know, I got a team of 8 guys and possibly a motorhome for you to stay in if you need it. Now, mind you, they were going to drive 8 hours to Orlando just to help out in our yard. That's the kind of heart that they have. And then 2 days after that, we were sleeping on tile floor. Anybody here in a hurricane know when it's hot, you sleep on tile floor, right? Because it's cool. And he said, I got you guys a hotel room, so you can have a couple nights rest. So that's the heart of this church that changes lives. And tonight is a free concert. And if you would like to do a love donation to this church, because this church changes lives. It doesn't just keep the lights on. It does that, certainly. But the money that is given changes people's lives and changes people's destinies. There is boxes in the back that say joy on them. So if you leave, when you leave tonight, if you feel led and you would like to give, we would really appreciate it. We're thankful for that. I want to tell you just a little bit of a story. This guitar is a 1955 Gibson J50. My dad bought this guitar for $175, which would be equivalent to about $2,000 today. But he made $5 payments on that every month. And he played music on this guitar for almost 50 years. And he came down and visited us about 3-4 months ago. And he brought this guitar to me. And he said, I want you to have it. And this guitar's got some stories to tell, because my dad opened up for Elvis in 1956. Yeah, he did. And they were in the green room, and guitars, Scotty Moore was Elvis's guitar player, and Bill Black was his bass player. And Bill Black was back there, and he said, "Hey, boss," and he was talking to Elvis. He said, "Come here." He said, "Look at this guitar." And Elvis had one exactly like it, except his had leather on it. And Elvis took it out of the case and started playing it. He said, "Man, you got a good guitar there." So that was Dad's conversation with Elvis. So he, there's a crack right here. 2 weeks after Dad got it, a guy put his foot through it, and it was repaired. And if you can see right here on the side, there's a notch right here where he played this guitar so much it bore the wood out. So when he gave it to me, this guitar's got a lot of memories. And I just sit down one night, and I'm like, "Man, let's tell the story of this guitar." So this is a song about this guitar.
Guitars played a lot of hang. Burl
Jamel Bost, right there, man. I just want you to know what a privilege it is and an honor tonight to be able to share this platform and to share these songs with y'all. We're so thrilled that Sandy is here and Nikki is here and Mel is just joining the church and he's going to be singing for us on Sunday, so that's awesome. And and Nikki's also going to be here Sunday. She's going to be showing up. That's awesome. But y'all are, I hope you've enjoyed it so far, because we're going to bring out Chloe. And she started with Sandy at the Farmer's Opera when she was six. And she sang like a bird at that point. I mean, she was awesome. And at 11, she was on America's Got Talent, and she was in the semifinals. And at 12, she played the Grand Ole Opry, and she shared the dressing room with Lauren Daigle that night. And she was just on American Idol last year. So please welcome Miss Chloe Chanel.
Hey everybody, how's it going? Thank you guys so much for letting me come and sing for you guys. It's an honor, and I'm so blessed to be here, so I hope you guys enjoy it.
Hidden glory in creation.
Like I said, I'm so glad, I'm so blessed to be able to sing and do what I love. And I'm also super honored to be on stage with these amazing and talented and awesome people. And I want to thank the pastor for letting me come and sing. Yeah, this is an amazing place to be, and I'm so glad. I don't get to usually sing Christian music a lot of the time. I'm always singing country music, and it's what I love, but country music and Christian music have a lot in common. They're both telling a story, and country music I can write and talk about my love life and whatever, but when it comes to Christian music, we can talk about the story and the life of Jesus, and that is my favorite thing to do, so thank you guys for letting me.
Every single lie that tells
you so, so much. I hope you guys are having a good time so far and enjoying the music and everything. You know, I am always busy doing stuff. Like, today I had school, and then right after I had to come up here. And I live in Pace, so it was like an hour drive or a 45-minute drive. I don't know, I was kind of going fast, so I made it here. But, yeah, like, I get busy sometimes, and I just don't think about some things. Like, I just let things pass me by. But music, I know, is something that I totally love and I'm obsessed with, because I can completely be myself and be honest with people. And some people like that and some people don't, but I heard that some of y'all have seen me on American Idol, and I'm just really, thank you. And I haven't decided if I'm gonna go back on yet or not, so I'll let you guys know because the season's coming up. But thank you guys, everyone, for the support. I did America's Got Talent, American Idol, and even though I got told no, I'm still gonna keep going. I mean, I'm only 17 right now, so I got at least 3 years left. And then I'm only left. I'm just kidding. But anyways, thank you guys. And this song I'm about to sing is one of my favorite songs. It helped me in a really hard time, so I hope you guys like it.
You could move this heart to be still.
thank you again for having me, and thank you to Mr. Mike here for hitting me up and asking me if I wanted to do this, and me saying yes, so I'm glad he did. Y'all definitely know this song, so don't fear, sing along, okay? It's called How Great Thou Art. Thank you.
Thank you.